हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. वेलकम टू सेंट मैरीज इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ज्योग्राफी ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी पार्ट 2 ऑफ आवर चैप्टर 3, ह्यूमिडिटी एंड क्लाउड्स. सो आवर फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज क्लाउड्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ क्लाउड्स. लेट अस सी व्हाट आर क्लाउड्स एंड देयर टाइप्स. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, क्लाउड्स आर फॉर्म ऑफ कंडेंसेशन at higher elevation, that means the higher heights. Now students, in this video we are going to learn about the various types of clouds. Condensation occurs around minute particles in the atmosphere. Condensed water or snow particles in the clouds are very fine and almost weightless, and so clouds floats in the air. Land and water gets heated because of the heat of the sun. Any other surface heats up, rises and becomes less dense. Hot air rises up. As it goes higher, the temperature of the air reduces and the moisture holding capacity of the air also reduces. Relative humidity keeps increasing. The water vapor in the atmosphere turns into water and snow. This is the dew point level of that air. The level of condensation is determined by the water vapor in the air. Keep in mind that students, the freezing point is also dependent on the altitude and water vapor. Now that is why because of condensation, fine particles of ice and water float in the air at a greater height. They accumulate around dust particles in the air and become larger in size, and their accumulation together is called a cloud. So understood what is a cloud? So when all these things come together and they become larger in size, this is nothing but what we see as it is a cloud. Students, sometimes when you look in the sky, sometimes what you feel that the sky is moving. So that is because of the vertical flow of the wind. That is why they float in the atmosphere. Like a kite which floats in the air as it moves higher and higher. In the same way, the clouds too float in the atmosphere because of vertical flow. Then the clouds are found at different altitudes above mean sea level. Clouds which form at greater altitudes are formed from very fine snow particles. Now see children, depending upon the altitudes, the clouds and its types change. Okay, now this is what we are going to learn in the further lesson. Now the process of evaporation and condensation occur consecutively in the clouds. Now, specific type of cloud cause rainfall on the earth. The proportion of vapor is more near the earth's surface. As we go higher from the sea level, the amount of water vapor decreases. Hence, the clouds at a lower altitude are larger in size, while the clouds at a higher altitude are smaller. As we go higher and higher, the size of the clouds becomes smaller and smaller. Now, clouds are formed at different altitudes in the atmosphere, and therefore we divide the clouds into 3 main types. Let us see the classification of cloud types. If the clouds are at altitude of 7000 to 14000 meter, then they are considered as very high clouds. Now you can see in this picture, if the altitude of around 2000 to 7000 meter is considered as medium clouds. Now if they are at altitude of less than 2000, then they are low clouds. Okay, now you can see in this picture high, medium and low according to the meter of altitude. So we are going to learn now all these 3 types of clouds. First we'll start with the high clouds. Now These clouds are mainly made up of ice particles. Now, can you tell me, children, why? Because they are at the higher elevation or higher altitude, where the temperature is very less. Now, further, they can be classified into, see in the picture, cirrus, cirrocumulus, and cirrostratus. Now, students, cirrus clouds are mainly wispy. Now, wispy means thin. These clouds are thin clouds. Cirrocumulus clouds looks like group of small waves, and cirrostratus are like a bedsheet with wrinkles. They generally have a halo around them. Now let's move ahead to our next type of cloud, that is medium clouds. Now what is medium clouds? Medium clouds include altocumulus and altostratus. Now, altocumulus are in the form of layers and have a wave-like structure. They are mostly white in color and have a gray shade. Altostratus are not very thick. The sun can be seen through them as if seen through a milky glass. Okay, now let us go to the next type of cloud, that is low clouds. Now let us study something about low clouds. What are low clouds? Now students, low clouds consist of five types of clouds, that is stratocumulus, which have layers. Their color is white to earthy. Round clusters of clouds can be here. Stratus clouds also have layers. They are ash colored and their base is uniform. The next is nimbostratus. It has thick layers. They are grayish in color and cause continuous rainfall and even snowfall somewhere. Now let us see the cumulus cloud. What is cumulus clouds? These clouds are formed extensively from 500 meter to 6000 meter altitude, and the vertical flow of the air adds to the formation of these clouds. They are huge and dome shaped and they are gray in color. Now cumulus clouds act as an indicator of pleasant weather. The vertical expanse of these clouds increases so much that they turn into cumulonimbus clouds and bring rain. Now let us study what is cumulonimbus clouds. Now these are characteristic clouds which are indicators of thunderstorm. Then those are dense and dark in color. There is thunder accompanied by lightning. They bring rain with storm and may sometimes bring hailstones. But such a type of rain does not last long. So what happens? As these cumulus clouds are there, and then later on if it takes turn into cumulonimbus clouds or big in size, then what happens is it starts raining. You must have seen sometimes suddenly that weather changes, lightning occurs, heavy rains which comes and it lasts only for some time. And then it stops. So these are cumulonimbus clouds. The top portion of these clouds has an anvil-like shape. Now students, anvil means, you must have seen in the pictures or in the movies, like iron workers use it to give the shape of the iron. They use it to shape the iron. Now, the clouds have a positive charge at the upper end and negative charge at the lower end. The land below them always has negative charge. Due to differences in the charges, electric charges are formed and lightning occurs, lightening up the sky for a just moment. The air around the lightning rises up because of the heat, and this leads to a large thundering sound. Now, as compared to the other clouds, the raindrops of these clouds are larger because they move up and down a lot of times and accumulate more and more water. Now, drops become larger and larger and are unable to float in the clouds, and because of their weights, they fall in the form of rain. Now even sometimes the air in the cloud is very cold, right? Now as a result, these drops freeze and fall in the form of hail, and we call it hailstones. I hope now this cumulus and cumulonimbus clouds is clear to all. Now students, there is one more, that is cloudburst. Do you know, cloudburst is a type of precipitation. Raindrops coming from towards the earth are stopped in the clouds itself because of strong vertical winds, and these drops change into hail. This makes the clouds heavier. The vertical winds are unable to bear this weight, and that is why it leads to heavy rainfall with large size hail. That is hailstone. This is called what? This is called cloudburst. It leads to rainfall of more than 100 mm in a small area or a particular region. This type of precipitation mainly occurs in mountainous region. The states through which the following the Himalaya ranges pass experience a such type of rainfall. Okay, now I hereby end my video. I will see you soon in the next lecture. Till then, thank you. Stay home and stay safe.